Hey everyone, it's Vikash from Skyline Motions. Today I'm super excited to show you how you can create an amazing text animation in Adobe After Effects. You can use these cool motion graphics to spice up your video projects and engage the audience. So no more waiting, let's jump right into After Effects and get started. I promise it's going to be easy, let's go. Alright, so this is Adobe After Effects and let's start by creating a new composition. So click on this new composition button or you can just go over here and take a new composition. This is going to be our main composition or render composition. So let's call it render. Set the size of this composition 1920 by 1080, frame rate 60, duration make it 5 seconds long, background color black, hit OK. And now we have to create one more composition that is going to be our media placeholder where we can drag and drop our image or video file. So just go to composition, take a new composition and I'm going to call it media. Leave the setting as it is, hit OK. Now let's import any image or video file for this animation. So just go to project window, right click on that, go to import file and select any image or video file. So in this case I'm using this video clip that I have downloaded from pixels.com and I will give you a link in the description. So select any video clip that you want and click on import. Now let's drag and drop the video clip inside of the media composition just like that, and then we have to fit the video clip inside of this composition just like that, and then go to the render composition which is our main composition and let's import the media into this render composition. And now we have to apply some effect on it, so just go to effect and preset. If you don't have this effect and preset window, then go to window and check this option effect and preset and search for tint effect. So just apply the tint effect on this media composition and make it black and white. And we have to apply one more effect, that is the brightness and contrast. So this is the brightness and contrast effect. Let's apply this on the same media composition. And here we have the brightness and contrast. Let's increase the contrast value something around 50, brightness minus 50, and make it like this. It's looking nice. You can adjust this value according to your image or video file that you are using. And then we have to create a video effect. So just go to layer, go to new and take a new solid layer. Let's call it effect. Select a black color. Hit OK. And now let's apply one more effect on this black solid layer. Just go to effect and preset and search for CC ball action. So this is the effect CC ball action. Let's apply this effect on the black solid layer. And here we have the ball size. So we have to adjust the ball size something around 25 and we will get this type of look as you can see. And then we have to select both the layers, right click on that, click on pre-compose, and this is going to be our video composition. So I'm going to call it video. Check this option, move all attributes into the new composition, hit OK. And then we have to animate the video clip. So it's very simple. Select the video clip, hold control on the keyboard and just double click on this rectangle tool just like that. And we will get this type of rectangular mask on this video layer. And then we have to animate this mask first. So just go to 1.5 second. Open the mask one. This is the mask path. Click on the stopwatch button to create a keyframe on the mask path. Just go to very first frame of this animation. Highlight these two control points. Hold shift on the keyboard. Press left arrow key and move these two control points and set it like this. Now we have this type of revealing effect. Perfect. Highlight these two keyframes, hit F9 to easy ease them. You can also right click on these keyframes, go to keyframe assistant and select this option easy ease. And then we have to highlight this keyframe, go to graph editor. If your graph editor not looking like this, then right click on that, click on editor speed graph, and then highlight this point, hold this handle and drag it on the left hand side. And now we will get this type of smooth animation. Perfect. Now you can close the graph editor and we have to animate one more thing. Just select the video composition, hit P on the keyboard to bring out the position property. Just go to frame number 30, which is equal to half a second. Lock the position as it is by clicking on this stopwatch button. Just go to 2 seconds. Move the video clip and set it like this on the right hand side. Now we will get this type of smooth animation. After that, we have to create the end animation as well. So just go to 3.5 seconds. Click on the diamond button to lock the position as it is. Just go to the end of this animation. Again, we have to move the position of the video clip. Set the position X value 1600. All right. So basically, we have this type of animation. Now, select all the keyframe, hit F9 to easy ease them. And finally, we have smooth animation in and the animation out as well. Perfect. Now you can close the video layer. After that, we have to take one more solid layer. So just go to layer, go to new and take a new solid layer. I'm going to call it black solid. Select the color pure black, hit OK. Now we have to animate this black layer as well. So what we have to do, select the layer, hold control on the keyboard, and again, double click on this rectangle tool and create a rectangular mask on this black solid, just like that. And after that, select these two control points, hold shift and set it in the center of the frame, just like that. And now we have to animate the mask. So just go to 2 seconds, open the mask one, click on the stopwatch button to create a keyframe on the mask path. Just go to 0.5 seconds. Highlight these two control points, hold shift and move it on the left hand side and set it like this. And we will get this type of revealing effect. And after that, just go to 3.5 seconds. Lock the position of the mask as it is by clicking on this diamond button. Just go to the end of this animation, highlight this point, hold shift and drag it on the right hand side and make it like this. So basically, we have this type of animation. Perfect. Highlight all the keyframes. Hit F9 to easy ease them. Go to your graph editor. Here we have to highlight this point, hold this handle and drag it on the left hand side. Highlight this point, drag it on the right hand side. Close the graph editor and here we will get this type of smooth animation as you can see. Perfect. And after that we have to create animated line. So select the paint tool, click on fill, set it to none. Click on stroke, set it to solid color. And set a thickness of the stroke something around 12 pixel. You can set the thickness according to you. And after that, click over here, hold shift on the keyboard and click over here again. And now we have this type of stroke. And after that, we have to animate the stroke. So just right click on the shape layer, click on rename. I'm going to call it line, hit enter, open the line. Here we have the add button, click on the add and add this effect trim path. Open the trim path and here we have start and end. So let's animate the start and end. Just go to 2 seconds. Set the start value 50. Click on the stopwatch button to create a keyframe on the start property. Just go to 0.5 seconds. Let's set the start value 0. And then just go to 3.5 seconds, click on the diamond button and lock the start value as it is. Go to the end of this animation. Here we have to set the start value 100. So basically we will get this type of stroke animation. And now we have to animate the end as well. Just go to 1.5 seconds, click on the stopwatch button to create a keyframe on the end property and lock the end value 100 as it is. And then just go to very first frame of this animation, set the end value 0. And now we will get this type of stroke animation, but this animation is linear right now. So what we have to do, select these two keyframes first, hit F9 on the keyboard to easy ease them, highlight these keyframes, hit F9 to easy ease them. And after that, just go to graph editor. Here we have to create a smooth graph. So select the move tool, highlight this point, hold this handle and drag it on the left hand side. and create a smooth graph just like that. Highlight this point, hold this handle and drag it on the right hand side. Now you can close the graph editor, and here we have nice and smooth stroke animation. Perfect. Now you can close the line. Select this stroke layer, go to effect and preset and search for ramp. So here we have the gradient ramp effect. Let's apply the gradient ramp on the line. And here we have the gradient ramp effect. We have two different points. So this is the start point and this is the end point. So let's set the start point right over here, end point right over here. And after that, select two different colors. So I'm gonna select the first color, maybe pink. You can select the color according to you. And I'm gonna select the end color, maybe the orange or yellow. Hit OK. And we will get this type of gradient color. And now it's looking much more interesting, as you can see. And after that, we have to create our main text animation. So what we have to do, select the text tool, go to character and select your favorite font style. So in this case, I'm using this Barlow font style. I'm gonna set the style maybe light. Set the size of the font 150 pixel, character spacing auto, and then click over here and type anything, whatever you like. Just like that. Hit Ctrl A to highlight all, go to paragraph and click on this option, left align text, because I have to place this text on the left hand side. And then select these two lines, go to character, and here we have to change the style. I'm gonna set the medium or semi bold, and now it's looking interesting, as you can see. After that, select the move tool and place the text right over here. Perfect. And now we have to animate the text. So open the text layer and you have to select a white color from here. It is very important. So select the white color and now just go to animate. And here we have to select this position. And after that, we have to select two more parameters on this animator one. So click on the add button, not the animate, go to property and select the opacity. Click on add button again, go to property and select the tracking. And here we have to set the position value something around 500, tracking something around 80. And this is the opacity, so I'm gonna set the opacity 0. Now you can open the range selector one, and here we have the start and end. So I'm gonna animate the start value. Just go to 2 second, set the start value 100. Click on the stopwatch button to create a keyframe on the start parameter. Just go to half a second, set the start value 0. Now just go to 3.5 second. Click on the diamond button and lock the start value as it is. Just go to the end of this animation, set the start value 0. And now we will get this type of animation. So what we have to do, just open the advanced, and here we have based on. So I'm gonna change this based on line, and now select all the keyframe, hit F9 to easy ease them, go to your graph editor, highlight this point and move the graph just like that. Highlight this point and move this point just a little bit on the right hand side and close the graph editor. Close this text layer, and here we have this type of text animation, and it's looking absolutely fantastic, as you can see. Now we have to do one more thing. Just click on the toggle switches and find this motion blur option and turn on the motion blur for all the layers. And then just go to very first frame of this animation, go to full screen and let's have a look. Alright, so that is it for now. I hope you guys like it. If you like it, then hit the subscribe button, turn on the bell notification for more interesting videos, and also hit the like button for this video. My name is Vikas and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye bye.